Windows is probably one of the more eight.
Oh, hey, I didn't see you there. We're just watching the latest NetworkChuck Academy video. We get early access because we're members.
Being a member has been awesome. You get access to great IT training, plus a killer community that won't let you slack off.
And there's no ads.
Oh, those ads are the worst.
I know, right?
This attack is devastating. Ransomware. Hackers create malicious software that when installed on your computer, they lock up your files and say, you're not getting them back unless you pay me money, a ransom, and then I'll give you the password to unlock them. This stinks. Companies are hit by this all the time. I've been at companies where it's been like, okay, all hands on deck, we're in trouble. It was legit scary. People lose money. And that's why Windows Defender, he's got some ransomware skills. Let's check it out. Getting back to our Windows machine, let's go ahead and launch our security. Our sanctum. And we'll jump back into virus and threat protection. I know, you thought we were done there. We're not quite done. We're gonna scroll to the bottom just a little bit. And you'll see right here, ransomware protection. Now, I have to say this. Having any of these features enabled for security is not a guarantee to go crazy and that nothing will happen to you. Microsoft Defender operates based on intelligence. We covered that in the last episode. He receives updates and he can only defend you against things that are known. He won't defend you against the unknown. So I only say that just to say, don't go crazy, okay? The best security is still you and not doing anything weird. But anyways, let's talk about ransomware protection and what it can do for us right now. Let's go ahead and jump in there. Click on manage ransomware protection. Now right now I really don't have it enabled and it mainly operates off a setting called controlled folder access, which will protect your files against threats like ransomware. And maybe, just maybe, it might even be able to restore those files if they do get infected. And what they'll do is actually just check to see if your files are being changed by unauthorized parties and prevent that from happening. Go ahead and turn it on. Here we can check a few things like block history. A history of all of these things that have been blocked from changing your protected folders. We can also go into protected folders and see what's being protected. Let's check it out. What's there by default? The good old user directories we talked about earlier. Mainly our stuff. Notice that's our personal user directory stuff and also the public, which is available to every user on the system. Now, one thing I do want to clear up here is that apps can still make changes to your folders. For example, if I'm going to download a file from a browser, Chrome or Microsoft Edge can access my downloads folder if I had that controlled. But it's only trusted apps that Microsoft verifies that are allowed to make changes to those controlled folders. But we can certainly change that. If you have an app that you trust that Microsoft may not trust quite yet, we can go into allow an app through controlled folder access, and you can add an app. You can browse it on your system here and add an app. And then of course, Microsoft down here is like, hey, you should set up OneDrive to help you really protect yourself against ransomware attacks. And all this means is that OneDrive is their version of Google Drive or Dropbox. It's where you can store your files in the cloud. And it's good. And when they say, hey, have additional options, it means in case your files have been ransomwared, been locked up, and they can't be recovered, maybe you have a clean, good copy in OneDrive and you can restore it. That's what it's talking about. So ransomware, it's a real scary thing. Having this type of setting enabled, control folder access with ransomware protection, definitely a thing you want to have enabled. Not foolproof, but hey, take all the protection you can get. That's all I got. I'll see you in the next episode.
You made it to the end of the video. If you want to see the rest of Windows Fundamentals and more great courses like it, go to academy.networkchuck.com. Link in the description.